Welcome back to In the Can. Right now we're going to talk about this great documentary that I actually have been able to see already. Director Kim Longinotto is here. Welcome.
Hi.
You're not new here at Sundance. You have a couple of World Doc Awards already.
Thank you for saying that. You didn't need to.
But just to give people kind of a little bit of perspective of where we're going, this movie is wonderful in so many ways. So it's a, I'm not going to say it. You tell us a story of Letizia.
Okay, well, I hadn't heard of her. Niamh Fagan, who's the producer, went to Sicily on a holiday and then saw her photos in a little museum there. And this, then she, you know, spent years trying to get it all together. So I came in, you know, not at the beginning. It wasn't like I met Letizia and thought, I want to make a film about you. But when Niamh suggested her, I thought, wow, you know, a transgressive, wild kind of, you know, free spirit, really.
Yeah,
that's
definitely
what she is. She's a free spirit. And I thought, you know, this is the sort of person you've been looking for. And I was, as I was saying to you earlier, a lot of women in fiction are so anodyne, and they're so kind of goody-goodies. And, you know, and here's a woman that sticks up for herself and is prepared to live by what she believes in, really.
Or die trying.
Exactly.
What she does is take pictures of the mafia. She kind of chronicled the mafia, mm-hmm. and the pictures are graphic, disturbing. And for them to have happened so long ago, she made amazing strides as a female.
Yeah, I mean, she was the first woman to work on a daily newspaper. So that's mm-hmm. she was very groundbreaking. And she left her husband, she left her kids, she went to the city to work. So she just kind of put her work first, which is something also that a lot of women find hard to do. They feel guilty about it. I don't.
But, you know, I.
Good. I thought you wouldn't. But you know, there's this idea that you shouldn't, and or you should feel guilty about it. And there's a point in the film where we say to her, "Is there anything you feel guilty about?" And she says, "No, I don't feel guilty about anything. You know, I put my work first, and that's how I've lived. You know, and I love that made me feel good. You mm-hmm. know."
Her work, though, particularly dangerous. She did. Talk or the film did talk about potentially she could be killed for what she's doing.
Yeah.
Because pictures are very personal of the mafia,
yeah.
very
very up close.
Emotional. Yeah.
And also, you know what really strikes you? I bet you've seen The Godfather and all those
sure.
mafia films. And Ollie and I, when we were in the editing room, we were watching the Godfather films and all those mafia stories. And what was so shocking is when you saw Letizia's photos, which are often, you know, women with their shopping bags over their arms lying on the ground shot down and their shoes off, you know, their stocking feet, or children gunned down, or guys in a garage with a rag in his hand that's been shot next to the car. You don't see that sense of ordinary people. You don't also see the sense mm-hmm. of how it affected people. A lot of her photos of people grieving, you know, and then she talks about how the police, the medics, you see a person being put into a coffin on the street and somebody very gently putting his feet into the coffin, you know, lovingly putting this guy in. So I think with the mafia films, it actually made me cross because I thought these guys knew what the mafia were. And they've made them into a joke, really. You know, somebody shot down. There's a wonderful scene we were nearly going to put in the film, which was at a little Italian diner, and he just shoots the people down, and you go off and you're on to the next scene. You don't think anything of it. You don't think they've got families, or what was it like for the kids in that restaurant to see somebody brutally shot in front of them? You know, you don't get the sense of what it actually means because it's not real. It's like comic book, isn't it?
It was very, but this film and her work made it very real. It was all of a sudden, there's nothing funny about the mafia. These people are traumatized.
Yeah. And they're cowards, these mafia. They shoot people in the shadows. Mm. They shoot people at work, unarmed people. You know, there's nothing on. She says men of honor. You call yourself men of honor. Mm. What's the honor in what you do? So, you know, I'm really glad we made the film, and I'm so proud of her. I think she says that every day she'd go out and think, you know, they're going to kill me today. You know, I mean, what a brave, amazing woman. She's like our hero.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, she's done amazing work.
And she's got
work.
Pink hair now, by the way.
I saw the pink hair at the end of the movie. I like the pink hair. What, yeah. How old is she now?
She's 84.
Oh, even better.
I know.
I love that. But, you know, it looked like and you'd be able to tell better, she was not unscathed by this either.
No.
I don't know how you could be. Yeah.
There's times in the film where she says, why are you making me think about this? And she talks about how she wishes she could burn her photos, mm-hmm. set fire to them, because actually she doesn't want to relive those memories. And in a way, there's a sense of it feeling quite immoral to take photos of people in moments of real pain, to take photos of, if you see a dead body in the street, you feel you should be respectful and stand back and sort of mourn for them. You don't feel like you should be kneeling on the ground taking a photo of them. It feels immoral. And I know that feeling really well from having filmed similar scenes in the films that I've made. You know, I once filmed a little boy when he'd just been dragged out of a river, he'd just drowned, and his mother's grieving, and you feel compromised by it. You feel that somehow you're doing something really that's immoral, you know, but then you think, okay, I have to take this photo. It, in a way, it's more immoral not to take it.
And don't you think that her pictures, because they're so graphic and so raw and so bare, spark change?
Of course.
Right?
Yes. It's not change that we can quantify. They're not immediate change. Mm-mm. It's not like you can say, oh, Leticia's taken a photo, you know. But it's a mindset. It's saying, look, we have to look at what these people are doing. We have to give reckoning somehow. We can't just pretend, you know, omerta, which they talk about, the code of silence. Mm-hmm. We can't pretend it's not happening. There was, for ages, they pretended the mafia didn't exist, the politicians. They said it was a myth. So I think, you know, it's bearing witness in photographs, and that has a real effect on a society.
Photographs, yeah, 1,000 words, right? Kim, it's so nice to have you here. Can't wait to see the movie. It premieres tonight.
Yeah.
At the Egyptian.
Yeah.
8:30?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. And Shelley several more times.
Leticia's going to be there.
She
likes it. She may hate it. She hasn't seen it.
Oh, I don't know how she would hate it.
Oh, I hope not.
Yeah, it's the best movie ever. Thank you so much.
You.
We'll be right back with much more of In the Can.